This right over here is a screenshot from a Khan Academy exercise, and it says Mason stands on the fifth step of a vertical ladder. The ladder has 15 steps, and the height difference between consecutive steps is 0.5 meters. He is thinking about moving up, down, or staying put. So let me draw this ladder that Mason is on. So it's a vertical ladder, so that's one side of the ladder. This is the other side of the ladder. And it has 15 steps. Let me see if I can draw that. So this is the first one, two, three, four. Actually, I'm gonna run out of space. I need to make them closer together. So it's gonna be one, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, and 15. 15 steps. Let me make sure it's even. So on the top and the bottom. And the distance between each of these, I guess you could say steps or the rungs of the ladder, are half a meter. So this distance right over here is 0.5 meters. And it says that he's on the fifth step of this vertical ladder. So he's on the fifth step. So one, two, three, four, five. So this is where he is right now. He's on this fifth step. And he's thinking about moving up or down or staying put. Let h of n denote the height above the ground, h, of Mason's feet measured in meters after moving n steps. If Mason went down the ladder, n is negative. All right, h of n, so when he is the height above the ground after moving n steps. So let's just make sure we understand this. If I were to say h of 0, what is that going to be? Well, h of 0 means that he's moved 0 steps. If he's moved 0 steps, he's still going to be on this fifth step of the ladder. And so how high is he going to be? So if he's on the fifth step of a vertical ladder, so he is going to be, so I'm assuming that there's 0.5 from the ground, so this is the ground right over here. So he is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 steps. Each of them is half a meter, so 5 times 0.5 is going to give us 2.5 meters. So h of 0 is 2.5 meters. If I said h of 1, that means he goes up. H of 1 means he goes up one step. So here, n would be equal to 1. So if he goes up one step, h of 1, he's going to be half a meter higher. So is going to be equal to 3 meters. So we could keep doing that for a bunch of different inputs. So let me write that. That's going to be equal to 3 meters. But anyway, that's not what they're asking us about. They're saying which number type is more appropriate for the domain of the function. So the domain, just as reviewed, that's the set of numbers that we can input into the function and get a valid output. And it's clear here, see, we have to pick between integers or real numbers. Well, n, which is our input, that's the number of steps he goes up or down. So it could be positive or negative, but we're not going to talk about half steps. Then he'll put his foot in the air right over here. He has to take integer valued steps up or down. Or I guess he's taking integer valued steps. If it's positive, it's up. If it's negative, it's down. If it's 0, that means he's staying put. If n is 0, that means he's staying put. It's not real numbers. He can't move pi steps from where he is. He can't move square root of 2 steps from where he is. He can't even move 0.25 steps. Then he'd put his foot in the air. So this is definitely going to be about the integers, not the real numbers. This function right over here, the valid inputs, if I want to be able to input an integer. In fact, it's not even all integers, because he can't go down an arbitrary amount. In fact, he can't go up an arbitrary amount either. But it's going to be, the domain is going to be a subset of integers. And then they say define the interval of the domain. And we have these little toggles here to define the interval of the domain. And let's see. The lowest value for n, he can go as far as 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 steps down. And in that case, n would be equal to negative 5. And then the highest value for n is if he takes 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 steps up. And so that would be n is equal to 10. So the interval of the domain, and actually I just copy and pasted this onto my scratch pad. N can be as low as negative 5, and as high as 10, and it can include them as well. So I'm going to use brackets. So my domain would include negative 5. If it didn't include negative 5, I'd put a parenthesis. But I could put brackets here, and I could put brackets there as well. And I can actually, let me input it into the actual exercise. So I'm saying integers, and I'm as low, n can, I can go down 5 steps, and I can go up 10 steps, and 10 is also included in my interval. And then I could check my answer, and I got it right.